In today's exercise, we will examine the maintenance procedures for our Torus TR-200 3D tank cleaner. Torus 3D tools are highly effective for cleaning tanks, vessels, autoclaves, ducts, boilers, and reactor interiors. This Torus model is pressurated up to 15,000 PSI and features an extremely high flow rate up to 220 gallons per minute. With two separate inlet options and seven interchangeable manifolds, the TR-200 can handle a wide range of pumps, working pressures, and different applications. Perhaps the most amazing feature is that all this power fits through an 8-inch opening. The TR-200 features a handy external speed control adjusted with a Phillips screwdriver, as shown here. In addition, there are four grease Zerks located on top of the crosshaft assembly, one on the inlet assembly, and one on the pull ring. Take a moment to familiarize yourself with the main components of the TR-200, beginning with the inlet assembly, elbow assembly, crosshaft assembly, brake assembly, and interchangeable manifolds. There is also a pull ring with its own grease Zerk. Note how the crosshaft rotates freely when properly assembled. Before we dig into the maintenance procedures, let's look at the tools required today. You'll need 1/4 and 5/16 inch hex wrenches, a pick, snap ring pliers, a Phillips screwdriver, 3/4 inch open-end wrench, blue Loctite 242, anti-seize, and grease. We'll review the maintenance kits at the end of this video. Begin by placing the TR-200 on a workbench. Use a 3/4 inch wrench to loosen and remove the bolt that holds the pull ring in place. Set aside. Use a 5/16 inch hex wrench to loosen the four sealing screws on the crosshaft assembly and lift it out. Note the rectangular-shaped O-ring in the groove around the perimeter of the crosshaft assembly. In most cases, you can leave this in place. The crosshaft has its own carbide seat and high-pressure seal. Remove both of these with snap ring pliers. The seat and seal are wear items and should be set aside. You'll find replacement parts in your service kit. With the crosshaft removed, we'll tackle the inlet end. First, use a pick to remove the O-ring from the end of the inlet shaft. Next, use a 5/16 inch hex wrench again to remove the four sealing screws. Disconnect the inlet end from the body. Note the square-shaped O-ring in the groove similar to the one on the crosshaft assembly. The inlet assembly also has its own seat and seal. Use snap ring pliers to remove them for replacement later. Next, use a 1/4 inch hex wrench to loosen and remove the three long bolts that hold the elbow and brake assembly together. With the bolts removed, you can separate the two halves. A little twisting action will help loosen the gearing when separating, as shown. Your disassembly is now complete. Examine the wear items as shown here. When you are at this stage in your maintenance, we recommend replacing both seat and seal sets, regardless of wear, to take full advantage of your downtime. Begin reassembly by placing the carbide seat and high pressure seal in the inlet end and the crosshaft assembly. Apply a generous amount of grease to each part as you install them. Install the high pressure seal first, pressed in far enough to leave a 1/16 inch recess. The carbide seat will sit in that recess. Repeat the procedure with the crosshaft assembly. Set both assemblies aside. It's time to reconnect the elbow and the brake assembly. As the gearing comes together, repeat the slight twisting motion you used when disassembling. This will ensure the gears mesh properly. With the two halves back together, apply anti-seize to the threads and screw in the three through bolts as shown. Tighten with a 1/4 inch hex wrench. Next, mount the inlet assembly back in place. Brush anti-seize on the threads and replace the four sealing screws. Tighten with a 5/16 inch hex wrench. Now grease and replace the O-ring on the end of the inlet shaft. Repeat the procedure with the crosshaft assembly. The crosshaft assembly needs to be remounted in a specific manner. Be certain to line up the grease Zerks as shown. Remember to brush anti-seize on the threads here too. Tighten with your 5/16 inch hex wrench. Finally, replace the pulling ring on the brake assembly end. Apply 242 Loctite to the threads and use a 3/4-inch wrench to tighten. With all the components back on the body, it's time to apply grease to the Zerks on the crossshaft assembly, the inlet assembly, and the pull ring. It is important to fill the body with grease in order for the tool to operate properly. Your TR-200 reassembly is now complete. Before we wrap things up, let's take a look at the accessories and maintenance kits for your Torus. The accessories shown here come with each TR-200 purchased. There is an extra pulling ring, a hex wrench for changing manifolds, and two nipple extensions. Note the O-ring on the end of the nipple extensions. These are the items contained in the TR-200 service kit available from StoneAge. You'll find written instructions, an O-ring for the inlet shaft, carbide seats, high pressure seals, and blue goop anti-seize. In addition, the service kit contains two O-rings for the nipple extensions and two seals for the manifold. The overhaul procedures for the TR-200 are much more complex, and we recommend contacting the StoneAge repair department before proceeding with an overhaul. Plus, the major Torus components, that is, the crossshaft, elbow, inlet, and brake assemblies, can be purchased individually for replacement. Two inlet couplings and seven manifolds are also for sale individually. Contact your local dealer for pricing information. That wraps it up. Thanks for your attention, and as always, our technical specialists are on hand to answer any questions or repair issues you may have.